See, what is it, Eric the actor?
Well,
oh, here, look what it says here. It says, Eric is pissed you aren't picking up on him. Eric, I'm busy. I mean, I can't pick up on you.
We've had people on the show today.
We have also, J.D. spends time recording the stuff for you. He doesn't like recording my show, and then you leave it and don't play it.
You know what's amazing about Eric? So I have J.D. record his American Idol internet show.
Right.
And I'm listening to the clip. I'm going to play you a clip that's going to blow your mind. Eric gets on the show and won't talk on his own show. On our show, he wants to talk. They're even begging him.
I actually don't understand the show. It's supposed to be Eric's show. And when you were playing clips last week, even with all the technical difficulties, it was that the co-hosts who were talking most of the time.
Well, I'm going to play you a clip now from
Eric. I talked quite a bit last night.
No, well, listen to this. I'm going to play you a clip from Tuesday night's Eric's show.
All right.
And no one is allowed to talk during it. It's going to go dead. And you know, I was talking to Benji about this. It almost sounds like, he was saying, and it's true, Eric's show sounds like when you listen to these guys who go up in space and NASA is trying to communicate with the astronauts, and they don't really say much, but you can't wait to hear the next thing they
have to say.
Right,
you're anticipating that voice coming back.
So Benji said to me, it's like NASA when the guys go up on the moon. I said, yeah, it's a crazy show. And you'll listen to it. Now, it will go dead.
So you think you're on the moon.
Right. Well, I mean, listen to this clip and be amazed by how bad Eric's show is. It's amazing. And yet he wants to come on here and talk, but he has nothing to say on his own show. Here we go. Eric, the actor from his Idol show.
If you guys have any questions, please put them in the room. Eric, is there anything that you want to talk about or anything you want to get out there while we're on commercial?
No,
talk to me, baby.
Really.
Talk to me. Come on, Eric, talk to me.
Kleenex. What are you looking for?
Grab that Kleenex.
What is that? What's going on?
Something.
Come on, A. Talk to me, baby. What's going on?
Yeah, I know, Eric. You need to spit something out here. They ride our asses because we talk too much, and then when we don't talk, you just clam up. And you can't blame it on me saying shitty things this week.
All right.
T Love's Idol in the room wants to know who won last year's Idol, Eric.
Get back to San Francisco!
That would be David Cook.
San Francisco is all.
Like, what are you looking for me to talk about, though?
I don't know. You are hosting a show here.
Hey, well, you know, we're trying.
Right.
Oh, why don't you promote your store, Eric?
Yeah, I wouldn't want to get called a douche or anything.
Right. Yeah, go check out my store at jfsc.tv/ETA.
You keep giving out the wrong URL.
Anyway, there is a clip, and it goes on
and
on.
You know what? I have to say that Eric is consistent. He thinks his plugs are very entertaining.
Yeah.
That's all he has to offer.
Eric, it's the
worst. Nothing you say is entertaining. Shut up, witch.
Eric, it's a disaster, your show. It's a disaster. I mean, what is that? I mean,
Starters, it's not a radio show. It's interactive internet chat.
Oh, I see what he's saying. In other words,
what is he saying? Tell me.
He's saying you're sitting there watching American Idol. He doesn't want to talk every second during the show. In other words, you're watching American Idol, so he'll come in with a jab here and there.
So why don't the others know that Eric is not doing a show?
Because they're doing radio. He's doing something else. Do I have that correct?
They even say it's internet interactive chat. That's what they told me to tell you.
Eric is extra.
Why are they trying to get you to talk?
That would be the chat part. Talking is chat.
Yeah, but why don't you even? They're urging you to chat, and you won't. right, Eric.
I thought maybe he meant chat was writing back to the people he's on the internet with.
Eric is extra blotchy today. Take a look at him.
I answer verbally.
Right until they bring it up. He's blotchy as hell.
Oh, shut the fuck up, asswipe.
Why are you so red?
Because I'm kind of in a pissed off mood today.
Look at him.
Oh, he's got that red rash that he gets when he's angry.
All across his forehead. Yeah. All the way down through his eyebrows into his nose.
He's got like that Gorbachev wine stain on his forehead.
It's almost a wine stain.
But it only happens when he's really angry.
It's a mood blotch.
Eric, you're very blotchy today. Are you itchy on there as well?
No, I'm not.
Look how red you are.
Looks like it hurts.
I've never seen you this red. There's a big red square going down your forehead.
Maybe because he's coloring his hair an extra dark color.
God, I was shitting. I just walked in. Eric, you look like you got a disease or something. What, did you get bit by a bee or something?
No, a spider.
A spider bite?
A radioactive spider?
Yeah, he looks like he should be poisoned from that,
I'm going to be Spider-Man.
Did you get bit by an enormous spider?
No, but you're enormous. Shut the fuck up.
J.D., what is it?
You know, not only does Eric not seem to want to talk on his own show sometimes, last night, people are actually done interacting with him because the host actually had to ask for questions over and over, and no one would post any.
All right, Eric, I got to move along. You've got a lot of... Got a lot of show to get to. Take a look at that blotchiness. Maybe a cream of some kind.
Why is he so angry today? Clips from last night?
It's disgusting, Eric.
Right. Are there any clips from last night that I should play now?
No, I pulled some, but you shouldn't play them. They're horrible.
How about that opening? here's the exciting opening from Eric's show.
Here's up the judges.
Good evening.
Hi, welcome everybody.
This is the opening.
Tonight is the Kentucky auditions for American Idol.
And Gina is going to be a little late joining us. So I apologize for that.
How's that?
They're doing the auditions where they do the...
How do you like that opening?
Can I just... I'm not going to record a show anymore. I'm just going to post old clips because they're the same thing over and over.
Did you hear Tuesday night's opening? This is the real exciting opening. Listen to this.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to American Idol. Of course, Eric, the Idol expert. And what's up, people? Good evening.
That was it. Can't even hear them.
We didn't have any music.
Hey, how are you?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, you did.
I'm
you
good.
You couldn't
how
hear
are you?
He,
good.
He's so out of it. He doesn't even know there's music.
Know what's
oh,
going
you know
on.
What?
Do
I
you
just
listen.
You know, I just realized he doesn't listen to the show.
Yeah.
Eric, the show sucks.
I can't listen to the show if I have the room unmuted. It causes.
But Eric, you're the host of the show. You don't even know there's music playing.
Right.
I mean, it's crazy what's going on there, and I don't have a lot of time to devote to this, but it's crazy. Ralph, go ahead. Do you want to make a suggestion for him?
Yeah, well, first of all, he is very blotchy. It looks like a car ran over his face. It's like a tire track.
Yeah, you're in trouble, Eric. Go to the doctor.
It's the size of a tire.
He's like Gorbachev.
Go to the little person doctor.
But you know what's more disturbing to me is his hand. Like, I know he can't do anything about that, but I have a suggestion. Eric, you should get, like, a fake hand that clips onto the phone. Like a normal-looking hand?
Well, why? I mean, that's his hand. Why should he have to hide it?
Ralph's onto something. Why do you have to go that far? Just get, like, black gloves.
I was going to say, what about gloves? Like a blind person wearing dark glasses?
Yeah, like the penguin in Batman Returns when you put the gloves on.
Stylish?
Yeah, like a little evil person who took over the world in his lair.
And he can pet a cat.
All right. What do you think of that, Eric? Maybe wear a black glove.
Or a cat can pet
him.
Welcome to my lair.
No, I'm not doing that.
Why not?
What about getting a fake face?
With a set of masks like Gary wears.
That'd be cool, a mask.
Yeah, like a hockey mask, like Tiny Jason.
Jason.
I bet like Hannibal Lecter, like one of those.
All right. Thank you, Ralph, for the suggestion. Eric says no. He'll stick with what God gave him.
How about a wig?
Thank you.
Eric.
All right, Eric, I got to move along.
Your show is shit.
Are you going to play the AVN interview clips?
I'm going to try and get to those, but I think that might happen tomorrow because it's running late.
Yeah, tomorrow. Turn in tomorrow.
Tune in tomorrow. No, Monday it'll happen.
Monday.
All right, thank you, Eric the Actor. There he is. He likes when I call him Eric the Actor.
Has a huge penis.
Eric the Actor, what is it, quickly?
I'm calling because, you know, Langford, what the fuck is your problem with me? You do have an issue. You say you don't, but you do. I had a customer that was willing to call in on my behalf and tell you the positive feedback about dealing with, or, you know, with me on the phone, but yet you shut him up and you wouldn't take his call.
Do you have a response to that? Are you anti-midget?
Is this Dan the Song parody? No, I get these all confused.
Right.
Good one, Steve.
Do you want to answer this at all, or you just want to
I have
it off?
No idea what he's talking about.
All right, Eric, thank you for the call. He has no idea what you're talking about. Go ahead, Steve.
Steve Langford has a huge penis.